Let me show you something weird on Google Earth. This river seems to cut right through these mountain ridges instead of flowing around them. How'd that happen? Well, what if I told you this happens because this river is actually older than the mountains themselves? As those mountains rose hundreds of millions of years ago, the river cut down through them like putting a rubber band around baking bread. At least that's what you'd think is true if you believe all of these Reddit threads. Unfortunately, it's not that simple, because science never is. So this river is situated at the north end of the Appalachians, and those mountains are old. They were uplifting and forming at least 325 million years ago. That's right.
Erosion.
Like they used to be the height of the Himalayas. Totally wild. But by about 65 million years ago, the Appalachians were basically eroded down to flat valleys full of some soft sedimentary rocks and a few hard rocks. And starting right then, there was a final little uplift that formed these higher plateaus made of harder rocks connected by all of these soft valleys. So the river did what any river would do, and it picked the easy path through the soft stuff. But in a few spots where there were some notches in the rock, it did manage to erode through a few hard ridges. But those giant ancient Appalachian mountains formed and then were totally gone way before this river ever found the path we see today. So according to actual geologists I actually talked to about this, one of the internet's favorite rivers is not what it seems. But the crazy thing is, there are other rivers in the world that definitely did exist before the mountains they cut through. Out in the Rockies, the Bighorn River cuts straight through this mountain like it's not even there. And that's because this river formed on a completely different landscape. Sheep Mountain used to be buried under miles of sediment from this much larger mountain range that eroded away and covered it up. Then the Bighorn River started flowing across what used to be flat land. As it carved deeper and deeper, eventually it uncovered that buried mountain underneath and just kept on cutting down through it. So the mountain was still technically there first, but the river kind of unburied it. But there are some rivers that truly are so old that the mountains they cut through rose up around them. Over in Utah, a block of land called the Sevier Plateau is slowly rising upwards while the Sevier River cuts down into it. This, finally, is a river that was there before the land started rising, and it cut its path as the mountains lifted up. All three of these rivers cutting across mountains in confusing ways might seem similar at first, but they all have incredibly different backstories. And the amazing thing is that we can uncover all these stories because, well, they're literally written in stone. If you're into this, follow PBS Terra for more.